me. Oh, 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 oh. Shake a leg with me.
Hello and welcome to Cry Hard 3 with me, John Smallwood, and
Louise Sellers.
So, yeah, we've got an unusual show this week in the sense that Whitty, the man who does everything,
who actually knows how to work,
literally everything, yeah, is actually away in London. So we're going to try and work out how to use stuff. Which isn't, there's a computer here which needs to go, but yeah. So it's exciting. We've still got our usual features coming up. We're going to have Whitty calling in later, but for the time being, it's just going to be us. So we thought we'd start off by letting you know what radio station you're listening to, assuming this works.
This is Bristol University radio station.
Nothing's
Burst
happening.
Radio.
Oh, anyway, I'm just going to grab this.
Not at all.
Oh, dear, dear, dear. But, yeah, so Louise, have you got any good stories from your week this week?
No, not at the moment, because I don't know what's going on.
No, neither do I. And my headphones aren't working either. This is going catastrophically. So,
yeah. Adam, we need you.
We need you so badly, Adam. So, yeah, it's been an exciting week for me. I've had my anniversary yesterday of a dating. So I went to Bath. That was really good fun. And we got I got a text off Laura's granny. And she replied saying, "I'm sorry, I can't talk now because I'm in Bath with John." And her nan replied saying... saying, "Oh, blah, blah, blah," whatever she was talking about, and then said, "Enjoy your bath." Now, we were a bit shocked by this and thought, maybe she thinks we're actually in the bath together. And then it transpired that's exactly what she thought we were doing. So we had that awkward moment where she replied saying, "Oh, you do realise I didn't mean the bath. We're actually in Bath together." And her granny replied, "Oh, goodness, I thought you meant the bathtub." So we're just wondering what was going through her head for the 10 minutes that we failed to reply. And she was sat there thinking, my
granddaughter. It did make me laugh, though, when I saw this on Facebook.
Yeah, exactly. We had to take it down, I'm afraid. But it was worth it for the time that it was up there. So, yeah. We don't know why our headphones aren't working, because literally none of our headphones are working.
Trying not to panic.
But we're trying very hard not to panic about this.
You know what? I think we should go into the first song.
I think we should. So, our first song is Bad Habit by The Foles, which is Adam. So I'm just going to press play and hope that something actually happens.
Hope for the best.
You're listening to Cry Hard 3.
Hello, my name's Annie Mack.
What's happening? This is Scream.
I'm DJ Ethan.
Hi, I'm Pete Tong.
This is Ethan Raffin, and you're listening to Burst Radio.
Burstradio.org.uk.
Burst.
So, you're listening to Cry Hard 3, and we're going to try and play our jingle now and hope for absolute the best. So, here we go. Never mind. So, that didn't work at all, so we're just going to have a little chit-chat.
I think it's because the song hadn't finished, John.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway... Yeah. Today, we're both very sleep deprived. I went out to Lakota last night. I wasn't drinking or anything, but I just didn't get any sleep. And I didn't realise how non-functional I was until I was lying in bed this morning, having woken up at 9:30, having only gone to sleep at like 5:30 or 6:30. And I was lying there, wondering to myself, what weighs more, 10:30 or 11:30? And it was at that point that I thought, maybe I won't be coherent enough to do a show today. But we'll persevere.
Mm. And I'm just pretty tired because I've had a very long week. And you know what I'm like with alcohol. I have one pint.
The one pint wonder.
The one pint wonder. And I just feel absolutely awful the next day. So I went to this restaurant, which turned out to be a cider place, and had one cider that was 6.6%. So I had one pint. And I was like, at the end of it, I was loving it. I was feeling great. So I was like, you know, I'm gonna have a second pint. I'm gonna have a second pint. It's going to be fine.
Mm-hmm.
So I had the second pint. And then quite quickly, it transpired that I was very drunk. quite quickly. And I think Laura might have noticed this,
yeah.
By the way, that I was picking her up and spinning her around in the street and making a bit of a hullabaloo.
Hullabaloo?
Yeah, that's a word that's not been used since the late 1850s. and then we went to see my cousin's EP, Danny Michaud, had just sort of made its debut in a local coffee shop, which lots of people had gone to see. But I was just there sort of like, I'm really, really drunk right now, trying to talk to my cousins, thinking they must think I'm an awful person because I absolutely reek of cider at this stage, having only had two pints. But I realised it's like, that was basically like having two-thirds of a bottle of wine in one go, basically, with the amount of alcohol that I had consumed.
Oh, John.
So
love you. Speaking of John being a strange little person, today I was greeted by him waltzing in wearing a tweed jacket with leather on the elbows and a fat cap, which I will be posting a picture of later on the Cry Hard 3 Facebook page. By the way, if you want to message us, you can catch us on the Cry Hard 3 Twitter page or on the Facebook page. And we also have a live player message board from anyone who's listening online through the Burst Player. What do we have coming up this week then, John?
Well, we've got a normal prank call from me, of course, which is quite good. And that's going to be me calling Pete McGowan again, who is the wonder child of my prank calling. Now, I've had someone say to me that my prank calls this week weren't particularly original in their thoughts. And to them, I don't quite know what to say over the radio to return, but I'm enthusiastic about it anyway. So I basically called up Pete and was like, why are you answering my calls? You know I'm really busy on Tuesdays. And then he's like, but you called me. and that was good fun. And then I did the same to my sister, who sounded even more confused. And then just because he's not here, I thought it'd be good to include Adam Whitty's prank call of my dad that he did a week or two ago. So we've got that as well. And we've also got your Imaginarium coming up, haven't we?
Yep, it's got some great ones in this week, I think so.
And you're in charge of the quiz as well, aren't you?
Yes, and I'm really excited. I put a good amount of time into making this, and I hope you both lose, if that's possible.
Yeah. So when we do the quiz, I mean, are we talking more difficult questions or just really mean questions? Or
You'll have to wait and see, really.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Well, some of it is a bit weird, some of it.
Ooh, you brought it up there for a second. I knew you had a cheeky look.
Yeah. Oh, oh.
Mm. So are there any good stories from your last night?
I found it's quite nice to go out sober. But the only problem is I almost fell asleep in Lakota at about 3:30.
I hate Lakota so much.
It was really good. What was the night? Hang on, I'll bring it up. I went to a night, I think it was called Adam Piff, and it had loads of different kind of music, so it had some electro, some 80s style stuff, and then it had loads of disco and funk, and it was just really awesome. Yeah. And it wasn't too crowded.
Disco and funk, really awesome. Yeah. Yeah, that's my kind of music.
Well, what do you like then?
I like music that most people don't like for good reason. For good reason.
That beautiful rendition of Careless Whisper that you did for Adam and I, which we can actually probably play through the radio right now.
Yeah. It's pretty good. I'm not going to lie. Basically, this involved me. I've become a bit of a pro with this. Playing Fisher-Price saxophone. So we'll just plug this in and play a little rendition of my wonderful saxophone. Now, unfortunately, the saxophone doesn't have quite as many notes as a normal saxophone, in that it has about six notes.
Yeah,
so,
Fisher-Price saxophone.
So I sort of had to I could play the first bar of George Michael's Careless Whisper, and thereafter it sort of just transcends into some horrendous failure.
Right. So, should we put that on?
Put that up. Nope, sorry, wrong one. There we go. Nope, wrong one. There we go. Got it.
I don't even know if that's working because the headphones aren't working.
Yeah, we don't know if that's working or not because
literally
the headphones
no
aren't
idea.
Working.
Well.
Oh, that's fantastic. How about now?
Let's carry on with the show.
No, it should be working.
One, go.
Yeah, it definitely makes my ears cry as well. But in a sort of proud way, you know, in a sort of, I'm just happy with myself being able to pick up an instrument and just learn it that quickly.
Right. Well, I think it's time we move swiftly on to Louise's Imaginarium.
Rich, I can do for you right now. I'm just going to bring it up. So,
John, be prepared.
I'm being prepared.
You're a terrible co-host.
I'm a terrible co-host because I've never done it before in my entire life.
Why did you tell me you knew how to work things then?
Because I don't know how to work things. So here we go. So this is Louise's Imaginarium, which will feature Adam this week. And I hope you enjoy it as much as we enjoyed making it.
Welcome to Louise's Imaginarium, where all my wildest dreams come true. Yay! Okay, so first idea this week is this is actually quite good for freshers, I think. So this doesn't really happen with guys, it's more of a goal problem where you go on a night out with your friends to
lounge or whatever, and all the guys disappear or find some girl to get with, and you want to go home, but you can't because you can't walk home on your own because you will get raped and die. So, my idea is a club-to-home guardian for girls who will walk them home. It would probably have to be gay guys.
Or eunuchs.
Or eunuchs, fine. Because we just can't trust men, apparently. Yeah, and so they sort of
or
be like...
Or butch women,
yeah.
Or,
yeah, okay, just people we can trust to not rape people.
Santa.
This is getting into interesting territory now, actually.
What, who won't rape women?
Don't really
want through our celebrity list today.
There's a new feature.
Yeah. Celebrities who won't make
Brilliant.
It's a good idea. I like it. I don't know how feasible it is. You'd have to have like as many men as there were women in the nightclub available.
Would they walk you home? Why? Well, couldn't they just pick you up in a with a bike or like a rickshaw or
yeah,
in
but
a taxi?
We're thinking overhead costs here, right? People. Quite cheap. Rickshaw is more expensive.
Surely you'll have to pay them anyway.
Yeah, but then you'll have to pay for a rickshaw as well.
That is true. She's got you there, mate. You look like a rifle.
Plus, walking is quite nice for sobering up.
Yeah, I suppose.
You can go via Donovan's.
Do they charge extra for going to the kebab shop?
I guess you can buy
them some.
You can buy them a kebab.
Have a bite.
Yeah.
Well, they get to high five some of the people in the shop, as drunk people all do.
Right, love you.
Oh, he's such a legend.
And then try and get your photo in there, which I remember happening on at least one occasion.
Look, we're going off the subject.
Oh, sorry.
So, yeah, yes or no?
It's a good idea.
But
it has teething problems. We need to work out how it works. As in, is it like a taxi rank? Is there just a rank of people?
Just waiting to take you home.
Like
a platonic sort of take me out.
If the first one looks a bit unkempt, can you go, actually, no.
He looks a little bit suspicious.
He looks a bit like not gay.
If it is a collection of gay guys, though, if you're putting a selection of gay guys in a long queue, is there not a possibility that they'll start flirting with each other and rather stay?
Only as much as if you had sort of just like general guys and girls in queues for anywhere in the world.
That's a fair point.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I'm just that if there was a queue of guys and girls.
People at a bus stop, like I've never seen anyone actually make it onto the bus. They're all just riding around on the floor by the time.
Because normally it goes elderly, young, and all over the age of 60.
I think it's a very good idea.
Excellent. Okay, right. My next idea is, let's have a look at the list. An automated barbecue. So, it's part barbecue, part fridge. this would take away most of the fun of cooking
that's
the meat yourself.
Yeah, but that's like not great fun, is it?
But it would be good, like, because you know how fleeting British summertime is.
Sure.
So you want to catch those good 10 minutes. You keep the meat in the fridgey section, you press a button, and then it flips over into the like cooking section, and Bob's your uncle, done.
Even better.
Yeah.
Link it to that Sky recording box service. You're on your way home from work, but it's raining in like half an hour. Press the button,
barbecue
and
now.
Your barbecue's ready by the time you get back.
Or you could have a thermometer, so whenever it gets to, say, above 20...
It just automatically turns on.
Yeah, like a thermostat.
Yeah.
But you'll get sick of barbecues eventually. What if we had like a good week? It's just constantly
cooking.
You don't
fill it up.
Okay.
Fill it up knowing that you're prepared for barbecue at any moment. Although it would often come out at midday, wouldn't it?
It would. Yeah. Oh, just ate. Yeah. Around, kids, it's time for another barbecue.
It was like April showers. It's sunny and then it goes windy and cold. And
automatically resets every barbecues. Yeah.
So you seem mostly in favour.
I think it's a good idea. I cannot see a flaw.
I mean, judging how my barbecue went for the summer ball, I think that it needs automating. And
the barbecue that none of us collected.
No, yeah, that's still in their house.
Yeah. Oh, no, I know what happened to that.
What?
Well, you might get angry at some people. Not me, maybe. We did take it from your garden. Now, we got one of your permissions.
Yes.
We climbed over your garden wall, took the barbecue out, and took it back to the person who I'm currently living with, old house, where it was there for a bit. Then we worked out a way to not get stuff in my car. We took it all the way there, Then I put it outside the back garden gate and said, person I live with, you need to make sure that you take this in. And then I didn't move in until September and recently asked where the barbecue was. It never got moved from outside the garden gate and no one's seen it since.
No.
Okay.
I'm really sorry, but it's...
Moving on.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was one use for a £25 barbecue, isn't it?
Someone's using it, though. We think we saw it in our neighbour's garden.
Really? Oh, wonderful. We'll go around and collect our £5 each.
Yeah.
But they're the ones we took the fridge from their garden, so it's okay, I think. Fridge is worth more than barbecue.
Are you all tramps around there?
High-class tramps.
Yeah.
Is it sort of like they stole it first, it's okay to steal it off them again?
Well, it wasn't really stealing the fridge, they just didn't want it.
Did they chuck it into your garden?
Yeah, we just plugged it in and made it work. Now we have three fridges. Makes sense.
Wow, it's alright, yeah.
Okay. One more idea? Okay, fine. You know how police have lots of different kinds of vehicles? So they've got vans, cars, ponies. What they need is...
Ponies! Come on, do your research.
Is there a scientific difference between horses and ponies? I thought ponies is just a nice way of saying horse.
I think there is a difference.
You laugh at me.
Ponies, horses are horses.
Sorted. Yeah, I didn't know that before. Thank you.
All right, no, they're subspecies.
I think if you ask Bill Oddie, he'll give you the same answer.
Yeah,
horses are horses, aren't they?
And ponies are ponies.
Drinks, perhaps.
Badgers are badgers, and you know, squirrels are squirrels.
Yeah.
Makes sense, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you both laughed, and neither of you can back up your answers. But we continue. So, more police vehicles. Police train. Police double-decker bus.
Police train. That's a nice idea.
Police barge.
Police barge.
Barge, yeah.
Who polices the rivers?
The slowest chase scenes you've ever seen.
I know for a fact that I can walk faster than a barge at full pelt, so it's not really good for catching anyone who's got legs, but it's fine. So, yeah.
I saw a police...
The police need to branch out.
A picture of a police tractor once, whether or not it was real, wasn't it? I've just got a picture of it on my phone, but that's no use for the radio.
When I lived in France, I met a policeman on a Segway, got a picture with him. So police segways exist. Yeah.
Do they have those in America or something?
Yeah.
Probably.
Security people use them.
That's right, yeah, because they're so quick.
It's good for chases through malls and stuff.
Yeah, in America.
Yeah.
But the police need to...
I like that. I like the idea of a police train.
I do as well. It's all right, though, because if it turns off its flashing lights and no sirens, so they'll see it coming. Yeah. Train in front of you, like, oh god, no, there's a police train behind us. How did that sneak up on us?
Well, there was that Top Gear episode where they put a car on train tracks, so you could just do the same thing.
What, like Back to the Future 3?
Yeah.
Okay.
Did you get my Snapchat, John?
Which one?
The one of the train full of cars when I was at Salisbury Station.
Yes.
It was pretty cool because I didn't know they did that. It doesn't seem the most logical way of transporting cars, but
no.
It was pretty cool.
Wasn't Skyfall?
Was it?
Yeah. The office product placement.
Yep.
Good radio.
So, anyway. Do you want one more, or is that it? Is that the end of the ideas?
10 minutes.
Okay. Alright.
We'll keep this bit in.
Okay. Should we have a quick pause and then I can do an ending thing so you can just slip that out?
Or leave it in.
Just leave it.
How well this records.
Okay. Well, thanks for listening. That's the end of Louise's Imaginarium. I don't know what. That went well.
So, that was Louise's Imaginarium, which obviously I left the end bit in there.
Yeah, we just got a quick disclaimer.
Yeah. All of the opinions expressed in that, including the ones that we were expressing, were expressed of Adam. So Adam's opinions, everything in there is Adam's opinion.
If you've got any problem with what he said, please go to Adam.
Yeah, address it to Adam, because he's the one who has all the negative and just negative opinions. Yeah. So up next we've got Louise's hippie song. Louise's song of the week.
I won't take offence.
She doesn't take offence at that sort of thing because she's fully aware it's true, so that's fine.
Yeah.
So what's your song this week, Louise?
My song is Love Will Tear Us Apart by Joy Division, that well-known hippie song.
Oh, that well-known hippie song. So should we play your jingle?
Yes.
That hippie song of the week.
Isn't that nice? And here we go. So it's Joy Division, Love Will Tear Us Apart. So that was Joy Division, Love Will Tear Us Apart.
Has it torn you apart, John?
It's torn me to pieces. I feel very, very hurt by this. So just in case you missed it the first time, we're going to play Louise's jingle again because I love it so much. So
that hippie song of the week.
So what we got coming up next then?
Next we've got Adam has recorded his middle-class Caucasian rap, and he took my request from last week to do a cover of California Love, although this version is actually Chipping Norton Love.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, he was going on about this. Apparently it's really good and he's very proud of it. So yeah, up next, Adam's Caucasian rap, and it really is the most Caucasian rap I've ever heard.
Isn't it? Well, it doesn't matter.
Well, here we go.
Caucasian.
Caucasian, Caucasian?
Caucasian.
Whatever, who cares? It's just rap. God,
jeez. Hello, John and Louise. This is my middle-class Caucasian rap for this week. It's California Love changed to Chipping Norton Love, with a bit of satire in there as well. I hope you enjoy it. Bye! Chipping Norton knows how to party. Chipping Norton knows how to party. In the county of Oxfordshire. In the village of Jeremy Clarkson.
Oh, wow.
In the village of David Cameron.
So
we keep it rocking. We keep it rocking.
You should send us into the council.
Now let me welcome everybody to the Cotswold Hills, a place that's untouchable like Golden Tower's thrills. The track hits your eardrum like a slug to your chest. Pack a jumper in your rucksack in the village of sex. We in Oxfordshire, where the bomb-ass rambling be. The county where you never find a farmer's market empty. And pimps be on a mission for them greens. Run a bean, money-making market stall servants' friends. I've been in the game for 1 month, making rap tunes. Ever since Buzz Radio was finally used, now it's 2013 and nobody listens or watches me, but I'm in David Cameron's constituency of Whitney. It's all good from Oxford to Banbury. Your city is the balm if your village making pay. Throw up a finger if you feel the same way. Whitty putting it down for Chipping Norton. Chipping Norton knows how to party.
Wow.
Chipping Norton. Knows how to party.
You should send us into their local radio.
In the county of Oxfordshire. In the village of Jeremy Clarkson. In the village of David Cameron. We keep it rocking. We keep it rocking. Shake it.
It's the best thing ever.
Oh, it's great. Deeply varying. You'd almost believe he was a professional rapper.
Can you hear a car going past in the background?
Can you?
Off the rail, looking for a trail, Chipping Norton dreaming. As soon as I stepped on the scene, I'm hearing beamers beeping. Feeding for money and a nice kitchen. The life of a Norton player where we're all rich and it's all ball. Only in Chipping where we live long and wear shawls. In Oxford we wear in tweed, not tracksuits. Dressed in coats and tweed suits and drive is what we do. But having caution, we collide with other 4x4s. Famous because we have lots of rich people. Let them recognise from Melrich to John O'Groats. With a Chipping Norton set. It's Oxford, so you know the set won't bow down to no man. Say what you say, but don't give me that trial for phone hacking. Let me serenade the streets of Chipping. From Chadlington to Ensdown, the Whitney area and back down. Norwich is where they put their Mac down. Give me love. Chipping Norton knows how to party. Chipping Norton knows how to party. In the county of Oxfordshire. In the village of Jeremy Clarkson. In the village of David Cameron. We keep it rocking. We keep it rocking. Next shall make it shake.
Oh, wow.
I think he's done Chipping Norton proud.
I think he's done it extremely proud, Louise. So proud. What have you been looking up right there?
Well, I looked at the Chipping Norton
Shake it, Chipping.
Oh, wow.
Are we still going? Yeah, I found the website for the Chicken Norton tourist info. And I found the...
Oh. Yeah. Churchill in the house.
Yeah, he's still going.
Roll right.
He is the most Caucasian.
The great roll right, definitely in the house. Carl Bright, Charles Bright. Hey, you know where Finstock is up in this. Hook Norton, where you at? Yeah. Great chew. Always knows a good tune. Even Chipping Camden trying to get a piece, baby. Shipston under Witchwood, where you at? Yeah.
Oh, that's amazing.
Anyway, as I was saying, I did a little bit of research just now into the Chipping Norton town, and on their travel and tourism page, I have found the contact details for Ken. So, Ken, if you happen to be listening, we're going to be emailing you your new advertising campaign.
Yeah, we'll be getting in touch with you soon.
Done by the one and only.
Don't worry about paying us for it, because frankly, we think the humiliation that will cause will be more than enough payment for us.
Sorry, so. Adam, if you're planning a career in anything involving... Yeah. Just people.
Well, just anything, really. You know, really. Any career at all, frankly.
Well, maybe if he runs for MP of Chipping Norton, then...
Yeah, you'll be very popular. You won't be competent, but you'll be very popular. I guess that's enthusiasm. That's something, isn't it?
Love you, really, Adam. Yeah. Please don't hate us.
Do you know what you're listening to?
What I'm listening to when?
Right you're now? Listening to Burst Radio.
Oh.
Radio.
That's what we're listening
to at
the moment.
I thought you were going to say... Our backtrack right now is Emancipator.
Oh, no, yes. This
which
is,
I'm sure has never
graced which has never been used
airwaves before.
Yeah, certainly not as a bed, since it's the most intense thing ever. But I'm pleased to say that after, what is it, it's been over half an hour, I finally seem to have got to grips with the computer system.
And the headphones are working.
We worked out what the problem was. Someone had unplugged them, God. always. It wasn't us, I don't think.
No, but that's embarrassing.
But we fixed the problem.
Try turning
problem
it off and
that
on.
Was, that wasn't my fault, actually, but, you know, whatever. Potato, potato, it's all the same.
Adam's going to be crying hearing this.
Adam is going
to
be crying.
Adam, you shouldn't have left us in a charge.
Yeah,
right?
I actually have to say, I have a little bit more respect for Whitty now, that he can actually do this and make it look so easy, because it really was not easy. yeah.
Do you want to do student solutions?
I do want to do student
I've
solutions.
I've got a good student problem for you.
Yeah.
Okay, right. So, this is quite a standard student problem, although I have a feeling you are... Is problemer a word?
It's
problemies are the people who suffer. I believe you would be a problemer in this situation.
I would be a problem. Oh, so I would cause this problem.
Yes, basically. So, student problem is, what do you do about that housemate who seems to make a lot of noise, various different forms, whether it be music or stomping around or whatever, and it could be any time of day or night. What would you do?
So,
solution me this.
I mean, I'm having trouble imagining that. Certainly not from me. No.
Yeah, I've never been woken up by jump by
by Van Halen.
Van Halen. I've never been woken up by that multiple weekends in a row.
Yeah, that did become a bit of a joke though. I knew that it was really annoying, so we'd just play jump to get me out of bed and like could just feel Louise's hatred come through the wall. Which were very thin walls, to be fair. I didn't realise.
Yeah.
I've got a lot better. So you've got a student solution for somebody who makes a lot of noise. If you permanently deafen them, then at least they won't have reason to play music, but then they might not become
aware. They might just turn it up louder.
That is true.
That
and they
could
might
backfire.
Also not realise that they're screaming in their sleep or that they're knocking over glasses on the way into the bathroom.
Are you a sleep screamer?
I'm a sleep screamer,
We'll have to get Laura on the phone to discuss this.
Yeah, I'm a sleep screamer. No, I don't think so.
It's a misunderstood condition.
I don't think I'm a sleep screamer, but... I'm asleep like near people. I like sort of make violent movements in my sleep occasionally. Not often, but when I do it tends to be like smacking people in the side. Not that I share beds with people very often, but when I do, I apparently seem to knee people.
Segue.
Yeah. No, it's my dad telling me this from when I was like on ski trip. I'm going
to
stop talking.
Anyway,
now.
Solution. That's what all
so
we want
one
is a solution to the problem.
Solution to the problem of someone making too much noise. You could impose a noise tax.
A noise tax.
Or you could do whatever they do, you do it again the next day.
That's, that's an option.
If they play Jump by Van Halen, which is a great song, by the way, you play Jump by Van Halen even louder.
But they clearly like it.
But they like it, but will they like it when you're playing it at 2 a.m?
That's a question.
I mean, obviously it backfires on you because you've got to be up at 2 a.m.
Yeah.
But, I think that's a pretty legit solution.
Has the technology been sorted yet for sound which you can direct at a specific person without headphones? I think I read something about that recently. I'm going to look into it, because if you could just point the noise at them,
Well, obviously you can like use a cone.
Just a megaphone.
Yeah, well, use a megaphone. There we go.
For everything you do, just use a megaphone. Fight fire with fire.
There we go. That's it. Just strap a megaphone to your face, like using some straps and yeah.
Yeah.
It's a good idea.
Your mind is a strange place.
Look, you asked for solutions. I had no warning of this. I was just going to try and think of some solutions. But I don't see the problem with playing Jump. Good song.
Maybe I shouldn't have asked you about this.
Maybe you should have asked literally anyone else.
You're a
about
problemer.
This. I am a problemer. A problem-y.
Problem. No, problem-y. I am a problem-y.
You're a problem-y. I'm a problemer. Speaking of making a lot of noise, this is just more chat. Yesterday, I was in the shower.
Where's this going?
It's going interestingly. Well, we've been doing, like, Adam Sayles and I have been doing a lot of pranks on each other over the past week as flatmates, and I can talk about this because I know he's not going to be listening. Basically, I've put garlic all over his room. His room stinks of garlic, and he still hasn't noticed. But I was, and it's become this thing where we unlock the shower door, we're in the shower, and just do stupid things to each other. Unfortunately for me, well, like, he and I planned that we were going to get Alex by, while he was in the shower, and he has really hot showers, going in and chucking an entire pan filled with, filled with ice cold water with actual ice cubes in it,
yeah,
and chuck it over him while he was in the shower. And I was up for this. I was like, yeah, we can do this. And of course, Sales was too hungover in the morning to actually do it. So yesterday, there I am enjoying my nice shower before I go to bath. And suddenly, I see the door unlock, and they've got this all on video. There was... No, I'm screaming like a little girl. And yeah, next thing I know, I've got a whole... like sort of pan, a big pan of ice cold water thrown over me in the shower, and I'm sort of screaming. So that's another video that I'll hopefully get later.
I'm so glad my house is more civilized than
yours.
Yeah,
well, I know. Like, you put, because Kelly goes away during the week, although Kelly was the one filming, so she's just as bad as us. But like, it sort of like descends into what it must
filming.
Be like to have. Well, she was filming.
Has your
yeah.
penis been caught on camera? Though?
No, it hasn't. It's too small. No, disclaimer, not true. But yeah, no, you'd have to have a pretty big camera. So, no, it hasn't, because I thankfully realised what was going on, but it doesn't make it any less painful. So, got anything you'd like to add? Any fantastic stories from the week or other student solutions?
No, because you haven't really adequately solved this one, so I might bring it up again next week when we will all be here!
Well, can we just drown whoever's making too much noise?
Drown?
Drown.
Like a...
Can't make noise.
Like a runty kissing.
Yep. Can't make noise if you're underwater.
How do you drown? Like, it's not easy to drown someone, especially...
Oh, you should be surprised. I mean...
John Smallwood, future doctor.
I'm obviously not being serious, or am I? So, yeah, no, feel free to bring it up. Or you guys can text in, or write on the group, or Twitter,
message
tweet.
Message us on Facebook, tweet us.
Yeah.
John knows all about tweeting.
I know all about Twitter.
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 For all the tweeters out there.
I knew he said something rude. Yes, for all those tweeters.
Anyway, coming up next, we have John's prank call.
Oh, yes, that's right.
Which you're supposed to be sorting out, aren't you, John?
I am.
You're
I
on top of things.
I wondered what you see. Louise has been giving me the eyebrows.
You've been doing the silent signals.
I just thought she was flirting. I was like, Louise, not here. God. But no, turns out she's
not the place.
This isn't the time or the place.
No.
So, no, I'm going to look up my prank call solutions.
Prank call solutions?
Well, that's what
get
we should.
Get your head in the game.
Okay, I'm trying to get my head in the game, okay? I've got Spanish. Oh, here we go. So, look forward to this.
Hello? Pete, what are you doing answering my calls on a Wednesday? You know I'm busy at this time. Look, mate, it's really not a good time for me, okay?
You're the one who called me.
Mate, don't do that. Don't use that excuse of me, alright? It's just a really bad time for me, okay? I'm going to have to call you back later, okay? You know I'm busy on Tuesday evenings.
Okay.
Good. Now, just go and think about it, okay? I'll speak to you later. Ciao for now.
Ciao for now. Bye. Why are you still calling?
Pig! Oh, God,
why
stop.
Are you still calling?
Stop answering my calls! God, I'm so busy! I'll speak to you later, okay? Bye.
Speak to you later.
Hey.
Hi, why are you answering my phone call? You know I'm really busy.
Sorry?
You know I'm really busy on Tuesday evenings.
I haven't called you or anything. What?
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 But you called me.
No, I didn't. What? I haven't used my phone, like, the whole day.
Well, that's not true. First of all, you've called me. And second of all, I got a text up you earlier. So you obviously have. But you know I'm really busy on Tuesday evening, so I would appreciate it if you didn't.
Hello, Jeff speaking.
Hi, is that a Mr. Jay Smallwood?
Yeah.
Oh, hello, John. It's Steve from Clifton Garage.
Yes, actually, I'm his father.
Yeah,
you're looking for John. Who's that then?
My name's Steve from Clifton Garage. I'm just calling to let... I was just wondering if you could pass this on. We're just calling to let him know that his new car, it's a Honda Civic. Well, we've had one ordered to our garage here. It's been delivered under his name.
He's a student. He hasn't bought a car.
It's under the name. We have the name Mr. John Smallwood from this, the address.
Sorry?
Yes.
Isn't that a fraud? What sort of Honda Civic are you talking about?
It's a red 1.6 litre Honda Civic.
And how old is it?
It's a 03 red, so from 2003.
I'm utterly unaware of this. It sounds like somebody's... I have to talk to my son because he hasn't got the funds to buy a car that I'm aware of. So, what's going? You're pulling my leg.
No, we have.
Why would you be ringing me at this time of night at the garage?
We've just had it ordered, and so we need to take the payment as soon as possible. We've had it imported from Ireland.
This is a blag. This has got to be a blag. So I'm sorry. This is a joke. Which one of his friends is this?
John.
Which is one of John's friends, is it?
So yeah, that was my
Your dad sounds like a happy person.
Oh yeah, he was. Afterwards he was not too happy about that for a few minutes. And I sort of won him over. And then he thought it was quite funny at the end of the day.
Mm.
But he gets cross if I spend like £10 over a month on alcohol. So for me to buy a car with my student loan would probably drive him quite mad. Yeah, but anyway, so that was good fun, and I'll try and do more prank calls that are sort of have a bit more substance than just asking people why they're actually answering my calls.
It's all right. There's always room for improvement.
There's always room for improvement.
Thanks. Anyway, coming up next, we have John's tune. John, do you want to play your jingle?
I'm going to play my jingle, which is thoroughly accurate. Why is he not?
John's pretty camp song of the week.
So, on that note, what's your song, John?
Well, Louise, I'm glad you've asked. My song is Elton John. Are you ready for love?
I am ready for love.
I'm ready for love.
Fire.
John's pretty camp song of the week.
I think that went pretty well. So, yeah, we have a special guest with us right now.
Adam, are you there?
Hello.
Yay,
yes,
it's working.
That is a load off my mind. So excellent. So yes, it's that time. It's the wonderful...
You're a natural, John.
He's just clicking all the buttons at all the right times.
I'm clicking all the buttons. I'm clicking them really well. They're just not working.
That's what she said. I don't even know if that works.
I wasn't going to say that, Louise, but thanks.
That's what John said.
Has my setup of all the buttons like your baby's house?
I can't really hear Adam right now.
Yeah, basically. Thank you very much for all of your instructions. Adam managed to write, like, extremely detailed instructions, and even that wasn't enough.
Right. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
It's the Weight Watchers Quiz of the Week, featuring John Smallwood and Adam Whitty.
Yeah.
Now, this week, I got to write the quiz... So, first up is John. Are you ready?
No.
No, never.
I'm so stressed right now.
Okay, so, what has a man from Newport, Wales been searching for in a dump this week? Is it A, his mother's ashes, which his ex-wife had thrown away during a messy divorce? B, a hard drive containing 7,500 bitcoins? Or C, the Philosopher's Stone after a very literal reading of the first Harry Potter book?
I'm going to go with the bitcoins.
That is correct. One
yes.
point to John.
Because there's so much in the news about bitcoins this week, I thought it would be.
Yeah, James Howells, an IT worker of Newport, Wales, threw away the hard drive of his old Dell laptop while clearing up his desk this summer, not realising that it contained a digital wallet of 7,500 bitcoins, which is now worth over £4 million.
Oh my goodness.
So, good luck, Mr. Howells.
It's probably worth it in the long run.
Yeah. Right, so that's one point, John. Next up, Adam, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. What did two Indonesian Air Force pilots try to smuggle into Indonesia recently? Is it A, seven valuable Australian parrots? B, a metric ton of cocaine. Or C, Gérard Depardieu, who had grown tired of Russia's chilly climate.
I'm going to go for the parrot.
You are correct.
I'm so disappointed that's not Gérard Depardieu.
Two Indonesian crewmen were found trying to smuggle a number of parrots, including five galahs from Australia, into Indonesia by hiding them in bags.
Wow. Some people.
So that's 1 point each. Next is John. What has a man in Dresden, Germany, been arrested for this week? A. Selling sausages which he claimed were made from pork but were in fact made from whatever roadkill he could find that week. B. Attempting to go on a joyride with a commuter train. C. Murdering and then eating another man.
Oh, they're quite grim. I was expecting the last one to be funny, but it was horrible.
Is this still a comedy show? Or?
Yeah, I don't know. Certainly not after all my failings this week, for which I'm truly... sorry, Whitty. When you listen to this later, you're going to be devastated. You're actually going to sort of wet yourself with sadness. Or erase it from your own memory. So I'm going to go with A.
A, you are incorrect. Oh. The correct answer is C.
Oh, goodness, Louise.
A 55-year-old man from Dresden has been arrested on suspicion of killing, then eating parts of a man he met online on a site used by those interested in weird torture fetish things.
Yeah.
Next up, Adam. So, in Shenzhen, China, why was a couple's wedding rudely interrupted? Was it A, the groom's pregnant ex-girlfriend burst in and attacked his current girlfriend? B, the ordaining minister died. C, the groom's father refused to let the wedding continue until the bride's parents could promise that their daughter would only give birth to boys.
I'm going to say C for that one.
I'm sorry, but you're wrong. The correct answer is A. During a wedding in China, the groom's pregnant ex-girlfriend ran in wearing a wedding dress and proceeded to wrestle with the bride.
Oh, wow.
According to Chinese online sources, the pregnant woman broke up with the groom because her mother wanted him to buy a property in Shenzhen that he could not afford. Tough times in China.
Pretty tough.
Did I ever tell you about the time, you know, when I used to work at Warwick Castle?
Yeah.
When they put on a wedding and Warwick Castle forgot to book the minister so they couldn't get married.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God. What happened?
That was smooth.
Did you have to do it instead?
They couldn't get married, and for some reason they were pretty upset, and that surprised me really. But yeah, they weren't very happy.
That's really selfish of them. Instead,
it doesn't take much to become an ordained minister. You can do it online, can't you?
You can do it in like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
Right.
I know several people who've been ordained by that, although I don't know what church they're ordained under.
Right. Next up, John. Here's question number 3. What is gymnophobia, otherwise known as A, a fear of exercise? B, a fear of people called Jim. C, a fear of nudity.
Fear of nudity.
That is correct.
Yes.
So that's 2 points to John.
It's never the obvious one when it comes to phobias.
And Adam, which of the following is not a real place name? A, Jesus-topia. B, go-go-go-go. Or C, half.com.
The first one, A.
You are correct. Jesus-topia is not a real place name. However, you will find Go-Go-Go-Go is a town in South Madagascar. Meanwhile, half.com is a town in Oregon who changed their name in order to receive $100,000, which they could put towards education.
Mm-hmm.
That's quite nice, really. Would you change your name for money, Adam?
Yeah.
Would you change it to half.com?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Well, my real surname isn't Whitty. I'm sponsored by a comedy company.
Oh, okay, yeah. That makes a lot more sense.
I'm not even going to comment on my surname.
Okay.
They wasted their money.
So, if I am correct, is that two all?
That's two all,
so
we are drawing.
So, we've got the decider question now.
Oh, brilliant. How does this work? Because it seems to change every week.
I don't really know. I hadn't thought about that. I thought it would just work itself.
So, is it like a buzzer?
Yeah.
Okay.
Should we do buzzer or should we do you each suggest an answer?
You each suggest an answer.
Yeah, okay, we'll do that then. This is less funny and more things you should know because you're both very British.
Okay.
So, what date is the Queen's actual birthday? Is it A, the 14th of June? B, the 21st of April, or C, the 25th of August?
So 21st of April.
I knew it because it's the same sort.
Well, you are both correct, and now I have no more questions. Congratulations.
So should we just say it's a draw? I mean, we'll just have a punch-up next time we see each other.
Yeah, I think that would be a fair way of working things out.
That's cool.
Although, fun fact, the Queen's official birthday next year will be celebrated on the 14th of June. So get your party hats ready.
That is right.
Okay, well...
What is it? She's like 87 or something.
She's quite old.
She's quite old.
Very old indeed.
Any excuse for a bit of a drink?
A little bit of gin with the corgis.
A little bit, yeah.
Well, Adam...
And probably a skag as well.
Yeah, exactly. Joyriding the golden chariot around London. The Queen has been caught doing 50 on the motorway or something.
She's allowed to drive without a licence, isn't she?
Just makes the rules, yeah. Oh, yeah, she is actually, I think.
That's fantastic.
Epic.
Right, well, thank you for calling us for that, Adam.
Thank you very much, Whitty.
That's okay. Good luck with the rest of the show.
Thank you. We'll need it.
I'd imagine me doing the best bits for next week is going to be a lot easier than it has been the previous 2 weeks.
Well, you'll just have two bits to choose from, so it shouldn't take you too long. No.
All right. See you soon, Whitty.
Thank you very, very much, Whitty. Bye. So, yes, that was our quiz, which we've drawn this week.
After that conclusive finale. Mm-hmm.
And next week, all three of us will be here, and Whitty will be in charge, I think, again, won't he?
Yes, and things will be fine, and there'll be no more problems.
Oh, yes.
So, anyway, now we've got our last song coming up, which is Adam's choice, The Best of Colston Hall, which is Caro Emerald.
Right, so, does Adam actually have a jingle for his...
Yeah, there's one.
Well, I'll play the first jingle because I didn't actually play it the first time around because I was too panicked by failing at everything else. So here we go. Here's his jingle.
He's trying to sound like he knows music. Adam's song.
So here we have A Night Like This by Caro Emerald.
So you've been listening to Cry Hard 3. Thank you very much for putting up with my incredible failures this week.
We're very sorry. Everything will be so much better next week.
Yeah. I mean, I thought it would be bad, but that was terrible. So, yeah, thanks. Up next is Unsaid with Steph and Annie. We hope you've enjoyed the show.
You're listening to Burst Radio.
I just knocked something off the desk. Brilliant.